guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to share with you my empties. So obviously since we're in quarantine, I have taken it upon myself to do some spring cleaning, which I probably would have done anyway, but I definitely went through my perfume collection and like redisplayed my perfumes, and I'm throwing like a lot of them away because they're totally expired. So in addition to that, there's quite a few other things. So this might be a two-part video again. I know you guys love empties though, so I'm not even tripping, okay? Here is everything I need to share with you. So we're gonna dive in and do fragrance first because it's the heaviest and it's also on top. I got my trusty Target bag right here that I'm gonna put all the trash in, and I cannot wait to see it gone. Okay, so the first one is this Lamb perfume. You guys, this was by Gwen Stefani. I used hardly any of it, oh my gosh, but I remember going through one bottle of this already. So I saw this at like Marshall's, I'm pretty sure I got this at Marshall's or something forever ago. And I know it was already probably expired way back then, but it's definitely expired now. But I just loved the scent. Like I remember just being obsessed with it in high school. So it was one of those like nostalgic purchases that I didn't need to buy, but we're getting rid of it. You guys, if you have not smelled Hanamore perfume, you need to go and smell it when we are out of this quarantine situation. It smells so good. I absolutely love sweet scents, but more like, you know, sophisticated and sweet. So not like super, super like pink sugar sweet, but more like I am 30 and I want to smell sweet, but not like I'm in high school anymore. So anyway, not you know, a diss if you like pink sugar, but regardless, this smells amazing. So there are two different types. I have no idea what the difference is. There might actually be no difference. Wait, what? Okay, they might be the same thing, but they're both expired. So I'm keeping one. I have three of them actually, and I'm keeping one bottle that's more full. And I honestly, that one's probably expired too, but I'm doing it. So, oh no, this is the Parfum. No, this is the Parfum and this is the Toilette. So they say they have the same notes, etc. But this one is the Toilette and this one's the Parfum. I like the Toilette a little bit better actually, so surprisingly. But like I just said, we're getting rid of them because they are so dang old. And another fragrance-ish item that I know I need to get rid of because there's no way that it's like, there's no way that this is not expired. But throwback, this is the Marshmallow Sparkling Lickable Body Butter. Wow. This is the Marshmallow Sparkling Lickable, oh my God. Carlene. This is the Marshmallow Sparkling Lickable Body Powder by Urban Decay, and it comes with a puff, looks like so. It has the sparkles, and you put it all over your body, and it's like lickable, and it tastes like marshmallows. I remember being obsessed with these. I thought these were the coolest things ever. I mean, I remember just being in love with this. I did get the honey one that just came out this year. I definitely picked it up when it was 50% off. So I am replacing the marshmallow one with the honey one on my vanity. I went through another Skintimate. I already told you guys it's my favorite. I already bought two more, so definitely would repurchase that. We're gonna go into a few hair favorites. I have been wearing my hair curly more often. I went 6 weeks straight without ever like touching heat to it. And then I kind of missed like playing with the curling iron, I'm not gonna lie. So I went ahead and flat ironed it the last few weeks. But I'm more conscious of what I'm putting on my hair. I feel like I'm moisturizing my hair a lot more. I am deep conditioning it. I'm really taking care of it. And when it comes to putting heat on it, I'm putting heat on it when I'm blow drying it. I'm putting heat on it when I'm about to flat iron it. Like I'm just more conscious of everything. So anyway, but I did want to share with you a couple of my curly hair favorites that I've been loving and some that I was not loving. So this is the Camille Rose Curl Love Moisture Milk. This stuff, you guys, smells so good. Like so good. So I've already repurchased this. There's another bottle in my bathroom already, and I love, love, love this product. This is the Kinky Curly Not Today. So I used to like this product a lot, and it's not that I don't like it. I just like this one better. So they're both leave-in conditioners, and I just like this one better. So I'm sorry, Kinky Curly. If this works for you, girl, then keep on doing you and buying it. But I don't think I'm going to repurchase that one. Going on with the Camille Rose trend, obsessed with the Cocoa Nibs and Honey Ultimate Grow Serum. I have not, like, noticed a difference of growth yet, necessarily, but it's only been a few weeks. So I've been using this for a couple months now. I would say my scalp is a lot more healthy now that I've been using it, though. So absolutely recommend this, and it smells so good, just like all the Camille Rose products. Camille Rose products smell so dang good, you guys. Oh, they smell so good. This is the Miss Jessie's Multicultural Curls Leave-In Conditioner. I am just not feeling this. I'm multicultural, girl. I'm biracial. That's what it's supposed to be for. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe I'm using it wrong. If you guys use this, tell me how you use it, because I definitely, I'm just not a fan. I'm not a fan. I don't even like the smell. Can't even lie. All right, you guys, I'm not kidding. Maui Moisture is my new favorite thing of all time. I have a couple Maui Moisture products. So I'm obsessed with Maui Moisture. I've already repurchased both of these. They're super inexpensive. I think they're $8.99. Each of these are $8.99. So super affordable. The Curl Quench Coconut Oil Moisture Milk. I love, love, love this. I've actually gotten to the point where I could actually just put this in with the Leave-In Conditioner by Camille Rose, and I don't even need to have gel, which is amazing. I love this. And again, Maui Moisture, like, everything smells so damn good too. And then this is the Maui Moisture hair mask for dry, damaged hair. This, you guys, so everything from Maui Moisture doesn't have silicones, parabens, no gluten, SLS, sulfates, synthetic dye, it's vegan, it's eco-friendly, pure coconut water, pure aloe juice are the bases. Like, everything is so good about this line. I can't even believe it's only $8 a bottle, but I've already repurchased those. Obsessed with them. If you have not tried Maui Moisture, you absolutely need to. Couple more hair things, and then we'll move on to probably body stuff, and then I'll do makeup and skincare in a separate video. So this is the Cantu Texture by Cantu Moisture Mask. I received this as gratis forever ago, and I liked it. Do I like the Maui Moisture more? Yes. So there's your answer. I liked it, but wasn't something to write home about. Okay, I've already repurchased another one of these. It's the Sexy Hair Smooth and Seal Shine and Anti-Frizz Spray, but this is actually a heat protectant. Yes, okay. I'm like, wait a second, is it? It does protect your hair. I really like this. I like that it adds shine. However, I think I will probably stick to my Dry Bar one going forward. But I do like that this is a fine mist. Ooh. It's just a fine mist, but I do like the mist of the Dry Bar one a little bit better, but I do like that product, the Smooth and Seal. So if it was on sale and the Dry Bar one wasn't, I would definitely repurchase it. I've already mentioned how many times I'm obsessed with this gel. This is the Aussie Instant Freeze Gel. Obsessed. I will probably not use another gel for a hot second. Like, I'm that obsessed with this. It just, ugh, I love it. It's $3.50 a bottle, first off, which is absolutely insane. And on top of it, it has pretty good ingredients for your hair. Like, it's not, you know, it doesn't have a bunch of junk in it, I would say. Does it? It might. I don't even know. So I love this gel. I can't say enough good things about it. It forms my hair curled perfectly. It seriously lasts probably like 3 days as well, which is also really nice. I just have to like reactivate it and re-scrunch, and then my hair is like day one hair. Okay, a couple body products. This is Drop It In Lotion by Soap and Glory. You guys, this smells so good. They sell this line at Target and at Ulta. This is the Magnifi Cocoa scent. I absolutely love this scent, and I'm pretty sure I have a backup of this already. I love coconut anything, so I'm definitely obviously going to repurchase this one. If I haven't already, honestly, I might already have one. I know for a fact I have a backup of this too. So this is the Kapari Coconut Body Milk. I'm telling you guys, anything coconut I'm obsessed with, especially for my body. I love the scent of coconut. So I love all Kapari products. I use the Kapari, just the pure coconut oil on my body and my hair, etc. But I love that this body milk, it's really, really hydrating, but a lot more lightweight. So I do like this one, and I would repurchase it. Pretty sure I already have already. Oh my gosh. I'm not lying, you guys. This is the Native body wash in coconut and vanilla. This is like, maybe I have a coconut obsession. I don't know. But I love Native products. I actually have another Native product as well in here. But the Native body wash, it's sulfate-free, paraben-free. The only complaint that I have about Native body wash is it's a little on the thick side. So it's sometimes like glumps out, like you get too much. But I just love that there is like not really anything in here. Like there's not too much in here. It's really simple. So if you haven't tried Native products, I love Native. Yes, like the deodorant might be overhyped maybe. I personally don't think so. I'm obsessed with it. So I finally finished my pumpkin spice latte deodorant. This is from the fall. I do have another pumpkin spice latte, but I'll just save it for next year, like, or later this year, in a couple months. But I love the Native deodorant. It smells so good, you guys. It smells so good. So it's time to let that one go though. And I've already repurchased them in multiple scents. And yes, one of them is in coconut. Honestly, I think I only have a couple more products, so I'm just gonna go ahead and finish the video. I went through another makeup remover cleansing towelettes. These are the fragrance-free ones. The only ones I like are the fragrance-free ones. However, just because I'm trying to be a little bit more like environmentally friendly, I probably will not repurchase these. You know, don't quote me on that. I might. If I buy another face wipe, it's going to be those ones. However, I'm trying to buy less face wipes because I'm trying to switch over to cleansing balms. So just keep that in mind for future empties. Finish up my Take the Day Off. This is a makeup remover for lashes, lips, etc. I like this one. I prefer my Lancome one, but I do like this one too. I finished up a Dermalogica Antioxidant Hydra Mist. I am obsessed with this, and actually when I left Seattle, somebody gave a full-size one as a gift, a going-away present for me, and I already have it open. I'm obsessed with the antioxidant mist. If you guys have not tried it, I highly recommend Dermalogica. I go and get facials and skin treatments from the estheticians at Ulta, and I love, love, love Dermalogica. They use Dermalogica products, so I have really fallen in love with that line, especially pre-cleanse. Pre-cleanse is my jam. Oh. There we go. So this is the pre-cleanse balm. I went through one of these. I don't mind the balm. Okay, wait. So it's just like, I think it's just a preference thing, like whether I'm feeling the balm or whether I'm feeling the oil. Like they're basically the same thing. They're literally the same thing. So the balm is kind of nice when I'm traveling, but also when my skin's a little bit more dry. And then the pre-cleanse is kind of nice because you can do it more quick and effective. I don't know. Because you have to heat this one up. But I like balms and cleansing oils and anything anyway. I'm really big on taking off all my makeup, like literally every last freaking drop of it. So I really try to make sure I take off all my makeup, like literally all of it, before I actually cleanse my face. So I'll wash my face like 3 or 4 times. I know that sounds crazy, but it's more like I take off my eye makeup, and then I take off like the rest with that same, you know, makeup off remover thing, and then I'll use a makeup wipe if I have them, and then I'll use a balm, and I'll like get everything off, I'll rinse it, then I'll use a cleanser, rinse it off, and then I use like kind of like a nice gentle scrub. So I mean, I'm super crazy about it because I feel like my skin looks better when I truly like take the time to cleanse it. But anyway, pre-cleanse balm, I highly recommend. Couple moisturizers, let's see. I love this one. This is the Confidence in a Cream. This is by It Cosmetics. I already have this one. I love, love, love this one. I didn't think I would like it as much as I did, but I really, really like it. This is the Tula Hydrating Day and Night Cream. I already have another one of these too. I really, really like Tula skincare in general. Both of those moisturizers, I would say the Tula one's a little bit more lightweight. The It Cosmetic one is for what I'm feeling a little bit more dry, and it has colloidal oatmeal in it, so it definitely hydrates where I need it to, but at the same time, it doesn't like weigh my skin down. So the Tula one I'll use when I'm feeling a little bit more oily, and the other one I will use when I'm feeling a little more dry, and then I use the It Cosmetics night cream. So just some clarification. Paracone MD Cold Plasma. I think I might have another one of these. I really hope I do, you guys. This technology is incredible. It basically helps anything that you put on top of it sink deeper into the skin with the crystal micro delivery system. I am obsessed with this stuff, so I really hope I have another one because, girl, that stuff's expensive. I would buy it if I had like $160 to burn, but I mean, not right now. Couple makeup items and we are done. So this is the Becca First Light Priming Filter. I've used it so much that it's like basically rubbed off. Love this stuff. I already have another one. Obsessed with that primer. And then these are 2 mascaras. This is the Clinique High Impact Mascara. I'm just not a fan of this. I don't like the wand, I think is what it is. I don't know. I don't get anything out of that one. And then this is the ColourPop Volumizing Mascara in the color Plum and Get It. I don't know if I've already mentioned this. I think I mentioned this as a flop, and I just hate this formula. I hate the formula. I hate the brush. It's the same kind of brush as the Better Than Sex brush. So if you like Better Than Sex mascara, then you'll like this one. And that's it, you guys. That is all my empties currently. We're gonna restart the empty process. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe before you go. And follow me on my social media. I am TikToking away. Oh my gosh, you guys, I woke up this morning to 1,000 TikTok followers, and I was so happy because I've only really taken it seriously and like started making beauty content on there for literally only 2 weeks. So it'll be 2 weeks today, and I'm already at 1,000 followers. So exciting. Thank you guys so much. If you guys came over from TikTok, that's amazing. Welcome to the fam over here. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.